I think you know in the Arab world it's forbidden to have a girlfriend or boyfriend. مرحبا everybody, كيف حالكو? How are you? I hope you're fine. This is a new Arabic lesson and I'm very excited to do it because you've been asking me like forever on how to say boyfriend and girlfriend in Arabic. I'm going to explain it to you in this lesson and to show you why we don't have a word for that in the standard Arabic, at least. In the spoken, yeah. And I'll show you all these differences in this lesson. Let's begin. Let's start with the word friend. Friend in modern standard Arabic, we say صديق. 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 My friend, that's a male friend. صديقي, we add this e at the ending, which means it's a possessive adjective. It means my, okay? Anything you add e, by the way, it becomes my. بيت means house. بيتي, my house. Let's go back to صديق. I'm gonna make this lesson a little bit quicker because there's a lot of information I need to condense in 10-minute video. And I speak a lot. All right, so صديق, that's friend. صديقة, صديقة, that's a female friend. And if I have a صديقة, it becomes صديقتي. صديقتي, instead of صديقة E, adding the E, I just told you, just add E, it becomes صديقتي. There's a reason for that, and I explained that that's a feminine gender, it becomes T instead of E. Okay, anyways, صديقي, صديقتي. If you say, هذا صديقي, this is my friend, you're just indicating this is my normal male friend, this is not my boyfriend. This is a friend, a male, a boy, that is a friend of mine, صديقي. And the same works with صديقتي. If you're a male and you're saying هذه صديقتي, this is my friend, this is a friend of mine, that is a, happens to be a female, okay? That's not how to say boyfriend and girlfriend in Arabic. Unfortunately, we don't have a way in modern standard Arabic to say boyfriend or girlfriend. We have the official or the social statuses that we added to our general lives, which is actually fiancé. When you are engaged, you have a fiancé. The feminine, the masculine is خطيب. خطيب. I have a خطيب. It means I'm engaged and I have a خطيب, a male. خطيب. خطيب. And the female is خطيبة. خطيبة. Even though خطيبة is not so much used, we say مخطوبة. مخطوبة, it's the passive. It means I'm engaged. That's an adjective. Okay? That's not the noun. Again, I'm trying all the grammar in Arabic and I can't find a way to say this is my boyfriend, this is my girlfriend. It's very difficult because I think you know in the Arab world it's forbidden to have a girlfriend or boyfriend. It's not. But I mean, we don't have a standard Arabic way or term to say this is boyfriend, this is girlfriend, like all the other languages. We have خطيب, the fiancé, and خطيبة, the female fiancé. I don't know if you call it also fiancé, the female one. And we have the word for lover, or beloved. So we can say حبيب, that's a male, that is a beloved. حبيبي, my beloved. حبيبي. And حبيبة, that's a female, and she's my beloved. حبيبتي. So حبيب and حبيبة are both terms that are like the closest ones to convey the meaning that these people are your boyfriend or your girlfriend. That's the only way in modern standard Arabic to express that you have a girlfriend or a boyfriend. You say عندي حبيبة, I have a girlfriend. عندي حبيب, I have a boyfriend. Remember, you're not saying girlfriend, boyfriend, you're literally saying a beloved. عندي حبيب, I have a beloved male. عندي حبيبة, I have a beloved female. But that's the closest way to indicating boyfriend, girlfriend. Now, when it comes to the spoken dialect, we simplify our lives. Especially in my dialect, in Palestinian dialect, you can say صاحب, صاحب. What is the meaning of صاحب? Now, صاحب on its own, it means friend, normal friend. That's the translation of صديق. صديق, if you remember, in modern standard Arabic, MSA, it means friend, and the translation of صديق, which means friend, into the dialect, it's صاحب. هذا صاحبي, this is my friend. It can mean both things, but usually we use it in the dialect to indicate this is my boyfriend, this is my girlfriend. We never say هذا حبيبي or هاي حبيبتي. No, we would say هذا صاحبي, هاي صاحبتي. Remember, you're just simply saying this is a friend, but it's mostly used, like 90% of times when you say عندك صاحب, عندك صاحبي, You are asking if you have a boyfriend or a girlfriend. So that's the only way that we can say I have a boyfriend. عندي صاحب, عندي صاحبي. You can also use the adjective. أنت, you are مصاحب. أنت مصاحب. مصاحب, it means you are befriended. You are in the situation of having a boyfriend or a girlfriend. أنت مصاحب if you're talking to a male. And أنت مصاحبي if you're talking to a female. That's the question. If you have somebody that you're interested in and he's or she's an Arab, you can ask them this question. أنت مصاحبي, أنت مصاحب, or عندك صاحب, عندك صاحب, عندك صاحبي, عندك صاحبي. Difficult because you can have a beloved of both gender. So I'm not homophobic. So I'm giving you all the variations. Very easy. صاحب, صاحبي, صاحب that's boyfriend, صاحبي that's girlfriend. And in standard Arabic, حبيب boyfriend, حبيبة girlfriend, beloved, beloved. All right. This is the only way we can say boyfriend and girlfriend. Unfortunately, we don't have legally or officially a word to, or we don't have the right to have boyfriend and girlfriend. We do everything in secret, and not today. In my gym, when I was younger, 15 years ago, it was a secret that we had to keep. Secret, by the way, in Arabic, it's sir. Huh? Secret is the word sir. We all have these relationships with a sir because because we're a little bit a conservative culture, which is good, which is not bad. All right, so these are the words to say boyfriend and girlfriend. I hope I cleared your vision, or I made you understand how to say them in Arabic, the different variations. Which one to use is use the dialect one. By the way, as I told you, Palestinian dialect one is mostly understood by all Arabs. So even if you go to Egypt and say sahib sahib, they will understand you. If you want to make sure all Arabs understand you, Habib and Habiba, the ones for the MSA, work perfectly and work wonders with all Arabs, because as I told you, all Arabs, we grow up learning the MSA, the Modern Standard Arabic, and it's a very difficult subject for us Arabs, imagine, because it's different than our dialects, but we all understand it. All the people that have studied in school, of course, and watch TV and read newspapers and books, they know and they understand Modern Standard Arabic. And that's why I encourage always my students to first study the Modern Standard Arabic, the standard language with all of its beautiful and logical grammar rules, and then move on to speak the dialect of their, or to choose the dialect of their preference or their choice, to speak it more. But if you speak Modern Standard Arabic, it's not a problem. It sounds like Shakespearean Arabic, but you would be speaking better than the Arabs themselves, which is good, not bad. All right, I spoke too much. I hope you liked this lesson. If you have any questions, any doubts, or any feedback, comment them below. And I will see you in the following Arabic lesson with me, Maha. Ma'a salama. Bye.
Marhaban.
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 هلا انت جاهز يا صديقي؟
جاهز.
مرحبا everybody.
مرحبا.
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 Hi.
That's your
aunt.
مرحبا.
مرحبا. مرحبا. يلا بردا.
يلا come here. مع السلامة.
Okay. شكرا. مع السلامة.
شكرا مرحبا.
شكرا معها.
شكرا معها.
شكرا معها.
شكرا مع السلام.
شكرا معها. سلامة.
شكرا معها. إلى اللقاء معها. مع السلامة.
شكرا كثيرا معها. مع السلامة.
مع السلامة.
مع السلامة.
مع السلامة.
مع السلامة.
Maha is a great teacher, the place is fantastic, so come. Yalla!